Guys, if you wouldn't mind, bring change! What's that?
How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, and welcome to Celtic Warrior Workouts. We're here at Busted Knuckles Gym in Tampa, Florida, and we have an animal of an episode ahead of us because we are here with six-time WWE World Heavyweight Champion and current Hollywood megastar who is known for his role as Drax in Guardians of the Galaxy and has just come off one of the biggest movies in cinematic box office history, Avengers Endgame. I am talking about the animal, Dave Bautista. So, let's go meet the man, the animal, and let's go do a bit. Dave, how's it going?
What's up, kid?
How are you, fella? What's going on, man? Oh, good to see you, dude.
How are you doing?
We're doing awesome, man. Right. Thanks for being on Celtic Warrior Workouts.
Yeah, my pleasure.
One of the most requested individual superstars, etc. to be on this channel. he hates it when I big him up, you know what I mean? It's great to see you, man. You're killing it, fella.
Yeah, thanks for coming, man. Yeah, welcome.
Appreciate it. I know I saw you at WrestleMania. I know you had your last match at WrestleMania.
Yeah, yeah.
But I didn't get a chance. There's so much going on at Mania. I didn't get a chance to talk to you much. But what's the story? What's going on with you?
Nothing. You know, I've been wanting to kind of wrap up my career for years. I thought that I would do it on my last run, but it just didn't go very well. And I kind of left like with that. And it's just kind of a bad feeling. And I didn't really have closure on my career. And I wanted to come back sooner. It didn't work out. You know, I wanted to close out my career with Hunter.
Yeah,
for a lot of personal reasons, and it just happened that this year we were actually able to make it happen. We really did kind of force it because he was coming off an injury, but he wanted to get back and make it happen because we're just, you know, like we're both 50 now, and you know, just like we needed to make this happen this year, or it just wasn't going to happen, and that would be something that would be hard for me to live with. So
yeah,
we made it happen. Funny thing is, neither one of us had been in the ring. He hadn't been in the ring in months because of his injury.
Yeah,
and I hadn't been in the ring in years. So the first time we were actually in the ring together was at WrestleMania. So considering, because I think the match was pretty great, and I think it could have been better, but it could have been a lot worse. It could have been disastrous, you know. But I felt like I'm proud that I went out that way. I'm proud that I went out on my back to Hunter. And I'm proud of my career that I had. So it was like a storybook ending for me.
It was awesome, especially all the history you guys had. Like I was just looking at some of the stats in WrestleMania 21. Yeah. It was it was in the top five highest grossing WrestleManias in the history of the company. Yeah. Obviously the stuff you did with Evolution.
Right.
But yeah, definitely. I mean, as the storyline goes, like especially from the beginning of your career to the end of it, it was awesome.
Yeah, and it was a personal thing for me too because. We had such a good history together that it made sense. It was an easy story to tell, but also personally, a lot of things that, you know, some of the things that people don't know is that, like, Hunter put me over three times clean to build my career, to make me a star so he could send me off onto my own, onto SmackDown to go ahead and start, you know, building other guys.
Yeah.
So he really, that's our tradition. That's what we do. You know, we make stars so they can make more stars so we can continue this legacy and this business. And he did that for me, and I never really got the chance to say thank you. And I never got a chance to give it back to him. And so it was a real kind of a monumental moment in my life and my career.
That's awesome. I love the match.
Yeah, thanks.
Especially being on the roster as well, coming in 2009 when you and Hunter were both super active as well, on the road every week.
Right.
But it's funny because I just think back as well, like you say, like, the last run you were here when you came back when Evolution when you, Randy, and Hunter got together, it didn't feel that long ago for me. Like the time goes so fast. I remember being FCW in Tampa and standing in the ring bricking it because I think it might have been FCW champ at the time. I was in developmental and you were we did a bit of a segment with you and me in the ring. I remember the whole time just cacking myself, just being like so nervous, you know what I mean? But like even back then you were like super cool with me. You put me at ease right away and I'll always thank you for that too, because that was another stepping stone for me to get onto the main roster.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, man.
But you're killing the fella, like when we talk about like the transition from wrestling to movies, man, it's been unbelievable, especially the Guardians of the Galaxy, the Avengers Endgame. You know what I mean? And obviously the Infinity Wars. It's awesome to see you doing so great, man. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Man.
It's I know like. sometimes people say when the wrestling career ends, like, you get to chill at home. Yeah. He's doing the opposite. His wrestling career ends, he gets busier and stays on the road even more.
I joke about it all the time because I seem to hit my stride in my career, you know, at 50. I turned 50 this year.
It's crazy.
And I'm more in demand and I'm more busy than I ever have been. So it's an odd place to be because I want to be retired. But I also don't want to miss out on these opportunities because it's something I love doing. Like, I'm really passionate about it. So, you know, so if somebody's offering you an opportunity, if you turn it down, you're an idiot.
Absolutely.
So I'm not turning them down, but there is a huge part of me that is ready to be home, you know, that ready to be retired.
Yeah. Well, we still get to be big kids even at 40 or 50.
I know, right?
You know,
I don't, I've never really had a real job. You know, I've had real responsibilities, and what I do, you know, professionally is a responsibility. But I've never had that, you know, 9 to 5 where I show up, punch a clock, and, you know, work all day with somebody over my shoulder. And always kind of, you know, I bounced for years and years, and I went into professional wrestling, and then I went into acting.
Yeah, I had the 9 to 5 job, and I don't think you're missing out on anything.
No, it sucks.
One of the things for me was, like, when I, like, you know, especially as a fan watching WWE, of course, before I got into it, was like when you came on the scene, just how jacked you were, how massive, like, obviously you're like killing it in the gym every day. Like, you could have stepped on an IFBB pro stage or the Arnold, or I mean, I'm just like, you're unbelievable shape, size, you know, asymmetry. And now to see where you are now, like, you've just, your training's changed. How much has your training changed?
It's changed a lot, and it did start to change somewhat at the end of tail end of my wrestling career, because I really got away from a bodybuilder look.
Yeah,
you know, I really wanted to have more of an athletic look. I wanted to go back to be more functional.
Right.
And so that actually led into me pursuing more fight style training.
Okay.
Which again, I became very passionate about. I was an amateur wrestler as well, and I kind of went back to those grassroots of my training.
Right.
And for a few different reasons, for health and also for my profession, because even at my size now, which is a very slimmed down version of me, still next year, average actor, I look like a gorilla. I mean, I'm just a large person. I have a big head, I have broad shoulders, I have long monkey arms. I look like a gorilla standing next to most people.
And you still look pretty big to me, man. I was standing beside you. You know what I mean? It fills out the shirt pretty well. No, Josh Rafferty, you sitting over there. You started training with him MMA as well. He's star of UFC Ultimate Fighter Season 1, which he doesn't want me to say. Yeah. He's hating me, but also a professional MMA coach. Yeah. He's training former, like, Jack Swagger, Jake Hager now.
Yeah.
But like, he's put me through the ringer as well. But it's just, like, as I said, like, I feel like the transition you've made to now, I think you look better. And you probably feel better too, right?
I feel great. Yeah, and I feel great, and I feel like I'm aging well. And I think just, you know, it was hard. I mean, it was hard work carrying around 300 pounds, 310 pounds. I mean, it was just, it was a lot of stress on my body that I didn't need, especially aging, you know, and all the injuries that I've had. I think that's why I'm in, you know, pretty good shape considering, you know, you see a lot of guys from, you know, come from our background who are just, they're just dying, you know.
They're all bent over, hunched over,
all kinds of hip issues. And, you know, I just, I think because I've varied my training and I've trimmed down a lot, I think it's really helped as far as my overall health.
Awesome. What's the most embarrassing song on your playlist?
Oh, God. There's nothing I'm really embarrassed about, but if there's, I mean, there's a few things that, you know, if I was driving, cruising along, and I had to stop at a light, I'd probably turn the volume down a little bit. But, like, I got some Barbra Streisand on there.
Really?
That I probably wouldn't be blasting at, you know, at the stoplight. You know? I love Babs. I have a lot of show tunes. A lot of people don't realize that about me, but I love musicals. Like, I'm a musical buff. Like, I love to go to the theater. I love, you know, if I'm in London, I'm at the West End. And they are not surprised to see me showing up.
That's awesome.
You know, to see Gypsy. I'm there. I'm all about it. So I've got a lot of, like, show tunes. So.
And you're also, like, you're a big fan of classic movies too, right? Audrey Hepburn is you're a big fan of her too, right?
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that, mate. The classics are classics for a reason.
Yeah. No, I'm like a little bit fascinated with, like, classic Hollywood, and I really romanticize that in my head. I mean, I think that's where kind of my love for films and Hollywood comes from.
But who, like, to work out with, who would you be your ultimate? Like, you could be MMA, bodybuilding, any style. Who would be your ultimate, like, person to work out, to train with?
It probably wouldn't be, like, the most exciting stuff, but Like, I really love that whole 70s bodybuilding lifestyle that in Southern California that was going on when Arnold was in his heyday training down there with Franco Colombo, you know, Dave Draper and all those guys were there. I would love to, like, go back, if I could go back in time, just get in on one of those workouts with those guys, you know.
Hit the Coliseum on the base in the 70s.
Living the life, man. Gold's Gym in Southern California and Venice. They're just training out there. No shoes. Just, you know, kind of, you know, booty shorts and no shirts and long hair. And they're just smoking a joint. just carefree life, man. That's awesome. It. Yeah.
So I know you said you're getting back into training.
I'm very busy. So when I kind of go away for periods of time, we'll come back and I kind of ease into it. And depending on where I need to be and how fast I need to get there, we'll kind of. I have two guys that I train with on a regular basis. Josh is Rafferty's. I've been training with MMA and functional training for years. And then the last couple of years, because I've gone a little bit more into bodybuilding training for the Marvel stuff, because I wanted to, you know, look more like a superhero.
Yeah, especially the Drax
training with Joe Bennett.
Okay.
But I've gotten back into, so now I'm getting away from the bodybuilding stuff because I just don't want to be as muscular. I don't need to be. I don't want to be. So I've started picking up my training with Josh. But
so we need to switch that around, just like curiosity for me and everyone watching. Like, mm-hmm. So like obviously you're going back into Drax role, mm-hmm. When you play that. Like, is there a period of time where you just hit the weights hard and that type of bodybuilding and look mm-hmm. for that, and then when you have time off, you just take a break and
go to something. Well, and because that's not really the style of training that I prefer.
Right,
I find it really. I don't know, it's just kind of boring. Monotonous. Like lifting weights, I did it for so many years. It is very monotonous, and I don't care to be muscle bound. I get muscle bound pretty fast, and I just don't care to be muscle bound. I don't think it's I'm single again. I don't think women are as attractive. I've found when I'm muscle bound, I feel like they take to me more when I'm trimmed down. I think it's because I'm less intimidating. I'm already I think upon first sight of me, I look like I just, you know, broke out of prison and ate someone's baby. I've been told that I don't look very approachable, but you know me. I'm
approachable.
I'm probably not what you would think.
I mean, Regal, I traveled with Regal in the beginning. He was like the first person to talk about you and how you were, he still couldn't get over that you used to be a professional breakdancer after all these years.
Yeah. It's so funny, he's one of my favorite people in this business. He's such an interesting guy. Like, I love him to death. And Fit Family was awesome.
Yeah,
like,
Fit.
That's like one of my favorite people.
The Malibu, was it the Malibu?
Yeah.
The Malibu. Fit will pick on something. Fit Family will pick on something.
Yeah,
like,
of course he will.
Do you still drink Malibu and Coke?
No, too much sugar. I got away from it. Yeah. I just switched to like vodka and soda. No?
That's probably, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was... It's probably still Malibu pop-up Coke is probably still better for you than whiskey, it's, like straight whiskey. To
why
don't
you just do like Malibu and pineapple?
Pineapple, that's what it was.
Pure sugar. But that was when we were spending all night, you know, all night, we were kind of dancing it off, and I was my metabolism was much faster then.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, I've altered things as I've aged and kind of been smart about that.
But that's Fit. Like, that'll be the story all the time. Like, he'll gravitate to one thing, and he'll stick it right to you. Trust me, he's got about 50 on me. So Josh is over there. I'll follow your and Josh's lead, whatever the workout is. We'll just call it an animal cardio workout.
Yeah, it's gonna be light, and then we'll pick it up a little bit towards the end, but not, you know. Nothing.
What do you want to call the workout?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I don't know.
Come on, Josh. All right, here we go. Let's go do a bit.
I've had issues. I had back surgery.
Right.
So, I actually had back surgery about a year later than I should have, and it left me with a bit of nerve damage in my left leg, so my left leg doesn't fire as quick as my right leg.
Okay.
So we've been using this to try to get just to get my left foot to fire faster, and it's just all with footwork and agility, because I'm naturally a pretty agile person, but because my leg is not firing like it should,
you
know, we use a lot of these to warm up, just try to get my nerves and going enough. But anyway, I've also had a knee surgery as recently as last year. So this is the kind of stuff we use to get back in shape and get more agile and stay athletic and not let everything all stiffen up and tighten up. But it's rehab pretty much.
Yeah.
It's rehab and warm up.
Okay.
You know, get everything working, footwork going. What we do is, to warm up our shoulders, so we put this against the wall, and we basically just do the alphabet.
All right.
But it really just kind of gets, you know, it just gets everything, start moving, lubricating, get some blood in the shoulders and stuff.
How are the shoulders feeling? Good?
Yeah, they feel pretty good. I still have a bad rotator on this side from years ago. I got a little injury doing jiu-jitsu. But, I'm holding up pretty good, I think, for, you know, someone coming from a professional background in professional wrestling. I mean, I've had a lot of injuries like you have as well.
Yeah.
So I think I could be feeling a lot worse. When I do feel bad is when I'm inactive. When I start to sit around and the rust sets in, I feel awful.
Even like long plane rides and car rides?
Yeah, but more like if I'm on set for a week, two, and I just can't work out, there's just no time.
Yeah.
And I really just start to stiffen out. My back hurts, my knees hurt, everything starts to stiffen up. So I need to get in here and work out and train. It just helps me, I just feel better being active.
That works great.
We'll do a couple.
Okay.
Scissor stepping.
Is like an issue for me because of my knee and because of my heart.
Crazy, you know?
This isn't for speed. Usually this is used for speed, but today we're not. This is just our day one, days back.
It's it's awesome.
Just, you know what I mean? You get the car in the garage, you can't race it the first day. You gotta drive around the block five times, right? We know better now. You gotta warm up.
When's the last time you saw Jake?
Who?
Jake Swagger.
I've seen him in a while, but I heard he's shredded, right?
He's lean and mean. And, like, I worked out with him one day. It's like, as soon as he gets his hands on you, it's like, God, just get off of me. And you're just like waiting for him to get tired, and it just doesn't happen.
Okay, bye, work next.
Yep.
All right.
Get this. You're going to go on this bag. Dave, go on this bag. Okay. Yeah, so basically what we're doing, this is our first day back, our intro workout, and all of our workouts are based on longevity because we want Dave to keep on kicking ass for as long as we can. We don't want him to get hurt. We don't want to do too much too fast. And so today we're just going kind of light, do a couple rounds in the bag, our agility warm-up, our shoulder warm-up, yeah. Some kicks, loose, some core work, just get flowing. Loose, get the blood flowing, and just rock and roll, have fun.
Rock and roll, man.
Rock and roll.
Brilliant.
This is what it was like wrestling with him.
I remember that match. And you were like, slow down. I was like, dude, I'm so excited. I can't help myself.
What was this?
10 beats of the power.
I remember the first time we did, and I came back to her. I was like, Jesus Christ.
Well, you can pretend this bag is me now, and you can kick the shit out of it.
No, no. I'll give it a hug. Well, that's actually, after you leave, we're going to put a big Sheamus face right there. And I'll hug you all the time. I don't know what everybody else is going to do to it.
That'll probably take
Jake is going to do that. Sure.
Oh, yeah, just kicked in right now.
So I'm gonna go all different directions. So I'm constantly moving underneath, over top. Dave's gonna go for 30. You're gonna go for 30. We're gonna rotate for 3 minutes.
Okay.
Let's tear it up.
Switch.
Yes!
Come on, Dave!
Come on!
Holy shit.
So that's a here for you, huh?
Yeah.
So how often would they be filming for, Dave, like Guardians? Like,
well, Guardians is typically, well, like the first one took us 7 months, but we were there really early for rehearsals and stunt training. And the second one took us just about 5 months.
Okay.
But the second one was also in Atlanta.
Right.
So the first one was London. So it was easier for me to, if we had days off, I could literally pop home. I could be home in an hour and a half.
Brilliant. Straight in a quick direct, right?
Jump on a plane, yeah, home.
Awesome.
But they're months at a time. But Josh will come, usually typically come on the road with me sometimes, and even to a film set, kind of stay. He doesn't know yet. I'm going to talk to him today about coming to Budapest. You got a passport, right?
I'm going
to
get it.
Okay.
I gotta find it. I know I have it. Anyway.
Because you got a great facility, but I need to trim down for a film I'm doing. And so I'm gonna be training and working at the same time.
Go the best. What are you weighing now anyway?
265-ish.
Jesus. Yeah. I'm 230. 235 now, yeah. But like 260. How is that trimming down? How is that trim?
It's like,
I was thinking like, it's jacked. It's like, yeah, right.
I got down, people don't realize it before. The first Guardians, I wasn't in good shape. I was in bad shape, but they covered me up with so much prosthetics.
Yeah.
Couldn't really see it anyway, but I had stopped weight training for a long time because I was trying to get roles in movies.
Yeah.
And then when I got the role, I didn't look. And that was part of the issue. That's why for the second one, especially Avengers, I wanted to be.
Yeah, jacked.
Yeah.
Yeah, you look great.
Yeah,
265, that's my, for a second there was something trimming down, I'm thinking like we're around, it's like, you know, 240, 235, yeah. But 265.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm right around there. I don't know where my weight's distributed. It's kind of, it's kind of.
Probably around here.
Yeah, I guess just a big, big bone structure. Kind of, not like you, like your bones.
Are, huh?
You got caveman bones.
Sure. Fucking night. No, I don't know where I came from.
Yeah.
They really got me out of some bleeding cave in Norway or something. It's just dragging me back.
Right. We were talking about, that's how I know, like when I'm really gassed, so I'm trying to catch my breath so hard and I just feel like I gotta take a leak on my stomach. Like,
I always get that before a match.
Yeah.
I have to pee about 50 times.
Nothing's coming out.
I'm like, come on!
No, it's just Randy. We love you.
We do love you, Randy. Super chill Randy is awesome.
Super chill Randy.
just not as exciting or eventful backstage as much as it used to be, but yeah, he's great, man.
Yeah, I rode with him. I mean, we were, he was young. Listen, when we first started on the road together, I was broken, he was young, so we were together. And between the two of us, we could get a rental car.
Right.
So He was too young. He wasn't old enough to rent a car.
Okay.
And I just didn't have any money. I didn't have a credit card, but he had like a credit card, and I would have the age, so we could get a car. And we managed to get ourselves to shows. But that's how it was.
Was that in OVW?
No, this was right when we left OVW. He left a few months before I did, maybe 6 months before he and Brock moved up.
Okay.
And then I was about 6 months later. I moved up. Yeah, so we all kind of came up within a year. Like everybody from that first class of OVW was up.
John came up as well, right?
Yeah.
You, John.
Yeah, it was a hell of a class. Me, Randy, Brock, John.
Shelton in there, was he?
Shelton.
Charlie. Charlie Haas. Yeah.
Charlie came from Cincinnati.
Okay.
He was, what was Les's place?
HWA.
HWA? Yeah, he came from there.
I've been on the plane with Rick a couple, like at the end, like obviously a couple of years ago, like on his last run up there, but I can only imagine what it was like having Rick there with Evolution.
Me too. So it changed my career, man. I mean, I literally had like two of the best there's ever been, like at my fingertips, like just picking their brains. And that's what we did. I mean, that's when, when you leave the show at night and you're driving down the road, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
Talk about the show. What happened? Go over it. And so that's what it was for me. I had access to these guys, and they were, you know, encyclopedias of wrestling psychology. You know, so I just picked their brains and hammered them questions after questions. And really, because it was a natural curiosity. I was curious. I was passionate about it. I wanted to know what made crowds react, and, you know, why they did certain things, because it was hard for me to figure out. Because when I came from OVW, it was like, you know, you do one move followed by another move, followed by another move, they just move. Now you really didn't know how or why they put them in order to make sense.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't know anything about, you know, finishes and that roller coaster of psychology. And that's kind of what I picked up. You know, it was, some of it was practical experience from being in there with them.
Yeah.
And then the rest of it was just asking them, drilling them with questions.
Which they loved, because they loved, like, people are always afraid, especially when I got up there too. It was like, I rode a Regal, and the same thing, I'd be in the car at Regal. Mm-hmm. When he didn't have the eye shades on and a neck pillow and the seat roll back. But I'd pick his brain too, and he'd be straight up. So for 6 months I had Regal critique my matches, and then, you know, like, went to Hunter and these other people, which got me a ton of heat, obviously, because they felt like, oh, he's only kissing arse. But the truth, just like you, like, you want to get better.
Yeah.
Who'd you ask to get better? Yeah. The best, you know? So that's pretty much what I did. And they want that. They want people that they want it, and they still do, but they want, especially them, like, they want to be asked, they want to help. Yeah.
Well, Hunter asked me to start, right? He said, when you want to start riding with me, you can. He said, when you start riding with me, everybody's going to say that about you. They're going to say, you're sucking up to me.
Yeah.
And he said, you want to make money? You want to make friends? So if you want to make money, come ride with me. I'll teach you the business.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah,
I get it. I know what you're talking about, man. I've been there.
Same thing with me.
Same thing.
Triple H, I worked out with him twice. I was Triple H's workout partner, buddy, was everywhere. But, like, as you said, like, you got a 20 heat out of it just for trying to get better.
Sure.
Which is funny. But.
Yeah, but I think that's what sets you apart. You get people who want it and who ask questions for the right reasons. And you get people, and I can always tell, people are asking you the questions because they feel like that's part of their job. They need to go up and pretend like they want this knowledge from you, and they just really want to, they just feel like they're doing their job. It feels false. There's a falseness to it. It's not a natural curiosity, you know?
Yeah, you can't really fake that. It's hard. You're just asking questions because you said, like, just to ask the question. Well, I went up and asked, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah.
When they come up and say, so did you get a chance to watch my match? What'd you think? And you give them this feedback, and you can tell they're not really processing this.
Yeah.
They're just, in their minds, doing the right thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cut!
20 off, finish 20 off.
Last set, best set. So am I starting on the ropes? Or no, he goes first, right?
Yeah.
No, we're the same time, right? We're switching?
Yeah, so same time, so there you go. Go. There you go, there you go.
That was awesome, bro.
Thanks, bro.
Thank you so much, Dave.
Thank you.
Josh, thanks for your
anytime. Anytime.
An awesome, awesome workout.
Yeah.
What do you got? It's coming back workout.
Yeah.
Especially with you being on the road all the time, getting back here, flying all over the place. I can only imagine how hard it is to stay on top of your fitness and training.
This is a part of like just being consistent too. Sometimes you can't go as hard as you would other times. But if you come in, just do a little bit, it goes a long way.
Yeah.
Just consistency, it's a marathon. You know, it's a marathon.
Absolutely, I totally agree with that. I totally agree with that. And we appreciate letting myself and everyone in Celtic Warrior Workouts into your home here in Tampa, Florida. Yeah. Thanks for giving us a run through on what you do when you're coming back, especially off the road. And again, I appreciate everything, Dave. It's been absolutely awesome. Appreciate it. Thank you so much, fella. Best of luck in Budapest.
Thanks, Josh.
Brave change. How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, just after an awesome MMA cardio workout with the Animal Dave Bautista. Tell him the brave change, Dave.
Guys, if you wouldn't mind,
brave change!
What was that?
Video coming to my Celtic Warrior workout channel soon. Subscribe now and see you first.
Brave change.